morning, everyone. As your master of ceremonies, I would first like to introduce myself to you. I am Emmanuel Gonzalez, a proud fifth grade student in Ms. De Leon's class. At this time, may I request everyone to please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance and our national anthem to be led by our very own Northeast Elementary Student Choir. Students and Ms. Espinosa, our music teacher. Students, faculty, and guests, this morning we are gathered here for a very special event. Here at Ortiz Elementary, we do not only place great value on academics, but also great importance on health and fitness. Our student body knows and understands that health and fitness are important factors that contribute highly to our academic success. Healthy bodies, healthy minds. That's what we're about. With that being said, we are extremely honored to have such distinguished guests joining us this morning to celebrate this very special event. At this time, I would like to call on Ms. Rodriguez, our interim principal, to deliver the official welcome and introduce our special guests this morning.
Good morning, boys and girls.
Good morning, Ms. Rodriguez.
How are you today?
Fine, thank you. How are you today?
I am very excited for today. You know that you will take part in today's opening ceremony of our fitness center. You will remember this day today. When you're in high school, in college, as an adult, you will say, I was part of that. I was part of opening that fitness center. So when your children come, you will get to see and say, I was part of that. Now, before we start with our presentations and demonstrations, I do want to introduce some very special guests with us today. I will begin with our superintendent of schools, Dr. Esperanza Sendejas. Board member, Ms. Minerva Peña. Area Superintendent Berta Peña, Carlos Guerra. We have our care partners, Mr. Rusty Rochot from the Lone Star National Bank, Sergio Garcia from the zoo, we also have Valley Baptist Legacy Foundation. Now this is a wonderful foundation that donated the equipment for our fitness center and also the curriculum that goes with it. So I want to introduce Ms. Evelyn Garza. Beth Pace. Athena Burnakis. And Judy Quinsenberry. We also have our special guest, Abel Gonzalez. He's an employee. They read up on you. They did. So at this time, I want to welcome Dr. Sendejas over to the podium.
Good morning, boys and girls. Good morning, special guests and faculty. I'm very happy to be here. Ortiz is a shining star in the district, as you know. Doesn't that deserve a round of applause? And we are extremely happy that you have been given all this equipment, because as we believe, exercise is extremely important. And we want to thank the Valley Baptist Legacy Foundation for their grant. So let's give Valley Baptist Legacy Foundation a round of applause. Thank you. I also want to congratulate the school, not only in its pursuit of excellence out in the field and activity, but its pursuit in excellence in academic standing. Ortiz is one of our top, if not the top schools in the district. So I want to congratulate the faculty and the students, because this year you made significant progress. Now, I know that this is not about academic progress today, but you need to understand, and we understand, and we value that the best students in this country are those that academically do well, but also physically fit and are active in every aspect of their lives. So congratulations to all of you, and congratulations to Ortiz. Thank you, Valley Baptist, for making this happen.
I want to welcome Ms. Minerva Peña over to the podium.
Thank you. And on behalf of the board, we love the Valley Baptist Legacy Foundation. Do we not love them? How much do we love them? That's not loud of us. I need to show them more love. Show them how much we love them. That's love. And I want to thank you, because this is the most important part of our lives, to stay physically fit, to stay healthy, to be productive, to make a difference in our community. And these are the type of organizations that make a difference, because this country was founded on people donating and volunteering of their time. Sure, we work. Sure, we earn a living. But this is the only country on the planet that is surviving on the donations, the kindness, the giving of the community that you live in. Because without those kind of people, we wouldn't be here today. And I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart, because you make a difference. And I told boys and girls, remember, we're going into the computer era. You're going into a lot of computers, a lot of sitting down time. So today I want to do something a little bit different, just because I think this is important, because you're going to be on the computer. How many of you get on the computer for 10 seconds and end up for 3 hours? Right? How many of you get on for just 1 hour and end up for 7 hours? How many of you go into the middle of the night and you forget you should be asleep, not on the computer? Let's be honest about that. So today, we're going to do something special for you. I want you to raise your right hand. Raise your right hand where you are and say, I promise myself that for the rest of my life, 365 days a year, I will work out walk,
or move
for 1 hour continuously. I promise that to myself, my family, my community, and especially my care partners, right? Yes, so today you have promised to stay physically fit, and 1 hour a day of your life you will work out and continue to be the awesome, outstanding future that we are looking at right now. God bless you. May you never lack for anything. May your cup overflow with Legacy Foundation to continue to do this and have a wonderful school year. God bless you, children. Very proud of you. Thank you.
Thank you, board member. I want to thank Valley Baptist Legacy for this wonderful grant. Here at Ortiz, we always strive for healthy lives. We want to live life to the fullest. Healthy bodies, healthy minds. We want to make sure we keep ourselves active, and this new equipment will definitely help us in our goal to keeping fit. As you know, diabetes and obesity is of great concern here in the area. We need to make changes in our daily physical lives, which you now promised, boys and girls, to do an activity for an hour. I remember as a little girl, we didn't have this type of equipment. In fact, I remember my mother would always say, "You can't be running. You can't be running. You need to, girls don't run. You need to be seated." She would say, "No andes corriendo. No andes corriendo, no corras. Porque las niñas deben de estar sentadas." And that's what I remember, that we were actually left for us to just sit and look pretty at times and play with our dolls. But I'm so happy that times have changed. Now, boys and girls are encouraged to do the physical activities. So we need to keep moving all the time. And all the time, we need to keep moving. Again, thank you, Valley Baptist Legacy, for this wonderful donation. Now let's give a big round of applause. And I'm going to invite Ms. Judy Quinsenberry to share a few words.
Well, good morning. It's going to be pretty hard to follow Emmanuel and also this terrific pledge for fitness. Valley Baptist Legacy Foundation invests in all sorts of ways to bring fitness to the community. So I want to really congratulate the principal and the coaches here at Ortiz who actually took the time to write a grant proposal. Eight organizations, eight elementaries were awarded this grant throughout the valley. So from Star, Cameron, Willacy, and Hidalgo counties. So you really did shine because we had quite a few elementaries write in proposals and you got it. So congratulations, especially to your principal and coaches who really saw the need for this and knew that this was a school that could live up to the curriculum challenges. And we know you boys and girls are ready to show us how cool this is. Have you had fun learning how to use the equipment? Good. What about those big hula hoops?
Yeah.
Good. Well, I'm so excited to hear that you like it. And I think that the more and more you use it, the more you'll like it and you'll enjoy beating your next personal record. So we can't wait to see what's in store in the next year or two, and we'll be back. We'll be back to see. So thanks very much and congratulations.
At this time, we would like to give a huge thank you to Dr. Sendejas and Ms. Pena for that beautiful speech. We would also like to give a huge thank you to Coach Cortinas, Project Fit America, and our sponsor, the Valley Baptist Legacy Foundation, for giving us the opportunity to receive the $25,000 grant for the state-of-the-art fitness stations. These stations will allow Ortiz students and myself extra opportunities to be physically active, healthy, and fit for many years to come. And now, as a token of appreciation, we would like to present this beautiful photo collage to Valley Baptist Legacy Foundation on behalf of the entire student body.
Thank you.
Next, it is my pleasure to introduce to you our Ortiz Elementary School cheer team and dance team. Both of these groups bring lots of spirit and pride to our school, and I am sure you will enjoy their upbeat performances this morning.
Thank you.
Thank you, cheerleaders, dance team, and sponsors for that outstanding performance. Next in our program, we have a very special guest speaker. Please put your hands together and help me welcome American Ninja Warrior, Mr. Evo Gonzalez.
I must say that Emmanuel is incredibly well spoken. Isn't that right? I'm already proud of him. Yes. Yeah. Awesome. I'm honored to be here for sure. This to me is almost shocking to see how organized and the performances and the speeches that are going on here today. Very, very proud to be a part of it as a guest speaker. I want to thank Valley Baptist Legacy Foundation again for what they're doing. As a child growing up in Chicago, I didn't have very many opportunities. In fact, if I tried to go to the park, I was probably chased away or tried to get beat up. You know, the people were trying to beat me up. So I had it very difficult growing up. So to see things like this now here in school, where you don't have to, in public, that's just an incredible opportunity to not only have an impact on the students and the faculty, but you as a community going out and then as a country, you know, us growing as a country. So that's awesome, incredible. Thank you guys again for that. I want to thank Project Fit America for selecting me as the official South Texas ambassador. That's something I'm very proud of too as well. Something that in my pursuit to be an incredible athlete and perform and be on a television show, these are just things that are kind of unexpected benefits, not even benefits. It's just opportunities for me to have a bigger impact. As far as being on television and competing, I really love that. I love what I do. I love representing South Texas, the entire state of Texas. But that's not where my heart is. My heart is having an impact here where we need it the most. I teach, I offer free classes, advice, I get thousands of messages and emails, and I do everything that I can. So it is a great opportunity to be here in front of you and to show you what is truly possible as far as fitness and nutrition. I myself got very sick. Some of you did see my video, right? You guys saw my video here? Yeah. Yes. What'd you guys think of the video, by the way? Yeah. Cool. It is just an honor to have an impact. Those things that I do, I couldn't do any of it if I didn't eat healthy. So that's one of the big factors that I want to get across. Training, going to the gym, and exercising is definitely part of being healthy, but nutrition is also a big part of it. If you can combine those with a positive, healthy mental attitude, there's nothing you can't do. That's all I really did to get where I am today. So again, thank you guys for everything. I can't wait to have fun out there. Let's go out there and make exercise fun, right? Let's do it.
Thank you, Mr. Gonzalez, for such wonderful, inspirational words. We will truly remember your message to us all. And now, it is the time that we have all been waiting for. We will be walking outdoors to the newly installed Project Fit America fitness stations for the ribbon-cutting ceremony.